Alright, on the draw here, this is a pretty reasonable hand. I can't cast Mardu Hateblade or Rush of Battle. It's on my planes, but this card is still fine later in the game, and this card is only good later in the game. I can already Morph Watcher, and I get to play Mardu Heartpiercer with a Flying Morph. So, I think that leads me to keeping here, especially on the draw. Seems like a reasonable place to be. Blue-green, huh? Well, wouldn't mind playing against a slow Soul Tide deck with this start, but my opponent goes Morph. I'm going to play Morph that's a Watcher, and if I've drawn, I guess I need to draw a land by turn 4. I get to smash and then Heart Pierce something. Seems like a pretty good deal, depending on what my opponent has, I suppose. Wetland Sandbar, then I draw. Oh, Molting Snakeskin. That is embarrassing. Well, it would have been Unyielding Krumar, which I'm not sure would have been better here, since I get to maybe put a Molting Snakeskin and a Watcher of the Roost and just get in there. Alpine Grizzly. Well, it's a good start. I drew a Plains, luckily. Let's play Watcher of the Roost face down, because my plan is still to hit with this, and then Heart Pierce, kill the Grizzly, block, and then have that to block the Sandbar. Seems like a pretty good plan to me. Alright, I will take the damages. I need a creature to trigger Raid, so I certainly cannot block here. Now I just want my opponent to tap out for something here. Though, I guess my opponent playing nothing is probably also fine for me. Let's tackle the Watcher of the Roost, see if that works out. Crippling Chill. Gross. Alright. Well, I'm going to play a Mardu Hateblade. And a Krumar Bondkin. Now, you know what? I think I just play the... Yeah, I'm going to play the Bondkin as well. Thought about just playing the Hateblade, giving it Death Touch, and blocking the Alpine Grizzly, but I think I'm fine just trading the Bondkin for the Grizzly, then that still sets up the Heart Piercer next turn, and I'll get value of Timely Horde Mate at some point, and that's one reason to block with the Hateblade, but I'm not worried about that. Alright, we're just blocking here. We're not going to block the Sandbar, we're going to go to 10. Did I awaken the bear? I'm okay with that. Because then I get to hit with the Hateblade and play the Mardu Heart Piercer here. Against an aggressive blue-green deck, Molting Snakeskin is probably not where I want to be, but I can always sideboard if I need to. Alright, well, I'm likely to get a raid triggered this turn at the very least. Though, well, it has Hexproof. Disappointing. Yeah, that's fine. Guess I still attack with the Mardu Hateblade. Or I just wait and then trade that off for a Whirlwind Adept. That's interesting. I could just wait and not play anything. That's so lame, though. Yeah. I'm just going to attack. My opponent's certainly not going to block. I think I've been Pierce Hearts here. Actually, I guess I should play my other land instead. And go ahead and kill the Wetland Sandbar. Well, it's a good Whirlwind Adept. Alright, well, I'm just going to block the Heart Piercer. My opponent's got a trick. That's fine. I can't really do much about that. I mean, next turn I'll block with the Hateblade, but for now, I'm blocking with the Heart Piercer. Hopefully it's not Awaken the Bear. I wouldn't mind a different trick instead. So I guess a Crippling Chill would be annoying too, because then I'd be getting 2-for-1. Whoa, what costs this much mana? Become Immense. Okay. Oh, Dig Through Time? Wow, that's a blowout. Become Immense I was fine with, but my opponent Digging Through Time here, unreal. Boom. Alright, that is the look of despair, since that's going to be tough to win now. My opponent's just drawing a bunch of extra cards for no reason. At least I get to hit with my Watcher of the Roost to leave Mardu Hateblade back. I'm probably going to Molting Snakeskin up the Watcher. Just because I need something. I wonder if the best play was just to pass. That seems so bad, though. What if my opponent has just a bounce spell and hits me for millions? Alright. So, that didn't work out, but what can you do? Molting Snakeskin Watcher. And attack you for 4 lives. And hope to draw one of my Ponyback Brigades or Time of Need or, you know, Warriors Call, whatever, make 3 Warriors, so I can end up in a spot where Rush of Battle is good. Because right now, it is not performing. I would love to be able to trade this Hateblade for a Whirlwind Adept, if that is an option. I don't know if it is, though. My opponent looks to be straight blue-green as well, though. I guess we'll see the truth of that over the next couple turns. I mean, once you've cast Dig Through Time, there's a decent chance you find your splash cards or splash color, whichever you're missing, or both. But this is a lot of islands. Crippling Chill. Yeah, that's the card I did not want to see. That specifically is the worst one. Well, suppose I'm taking 5. I get to lead back the Watcher. It can block and regenerate. And I could play a Timely Horde Maid, but I gotta get value here. Can't just not get value. Well, I might have to not get value. Nope, never mind. Play this face down, leaving regeneration up, and pass the turn. There's so many things my opponent could have that would wreck me here. I do get to gain 2 life at instant speed. That part at least is nice. Probably, if I had to reveal one of these 2 cards right now, it'd probably be Rush of Battle. Timely Horde Mate, you can play around a little bit and like not trade off for the Hateblade, whereas Rush of Battle, I mean, eventually I'm going to have a board where it's good to cast. My opponent can't really do much. I mean, it's not like my opponent has a ton of removal spells, and I'm going to make the trades I'm going to make, so I don't mind showing my opponent Rush of Battle if I have to. If my opponent could ever not have Force Away or Crippling Chill, then I could, you know, keep the shields up with this Molting Snakeskin, but it's not looking great for me. Since my opponent cast Dig Through Time, it has to have multiple good cards. Alpine Grizzly, not necessarily one of them. Well, Crippling Chill is easily a card I can believe selecting off Dig Through Time. Let's see what my opponent is up to now. Savage Punch, yes, that is one of the things I did not want to see. Alpine Grizzly fighting my Krumar Bondkin. Well, at least if my opponent has nothing else, this does go for lethal, but doesn't actually work. Who do I kill? I think I kill the Whirlwind Adept. Take 1 more point of damage, but I don't know if that matters. Let's regenerate. And let's turn this creature face up. Also, by blocking Whirlwind Adept, well, I guess any pump spell kills me, and my opponent have to have 2. I can't think of 2 non-pump spells my opponent could have that would matter here. Well, I do have outs, despite having no mana. Ooh, Watcher of the Roost. That might have worked out all right. I mean, we'll see in a second here, but It could be an okay thing to have happen, or not. What was that? Oh, Dragon Scale Boon. Sure. Was not beating that regardless. Alright. Blue-green all tricks. Do I want, like, a Rotting Mastodon? I don't think so. I just want a faster draw. So, we'll go for that.